playing tonight are fair rivals as members of opposing teams. The theme of interscholastic athletics is that of friendly competition. The division team in every interscholastic game is a guest of the home team and is expected to be so regarded and treated. Profanity and vulgar cheers are abusive to other spectators and are also a reflection of your school and community. This type of behavior will not be tolerated. People involved in this type of activity will be asked to leave with no refund or re-entry and may be banned from future contests or even cause your school to be placed on probation. A reminder that the use of alcohol, drugs, and tobacco are forbidden at all Mississippi high school activities. Air horns and bullhorns with sirens are not allowed at athletic events. Trash containers are located all around the bleachers and are expected to be used. Please don't drop trash through the bleachers in the event that there are people walking under you. Your cooperation is greatly appreciated.
Welcome to Jerry Boatner Field on the campus of West Lauderdale High School in Collinsville, Mississippi, where the West Lauderdale Knights will take on the Choctaw Central Warriors in a Division Class 4A Region 4 game tonight. The Knights enter today's game with a record of 13-4, coming off a 12-1 win over Northeast last Thursday. In that game, Dylan Brown was a winning pitcher. Brett Busby went 3-for-3, and Cade Kennedy went 3-for-4 for the Knights. Choctaw Central comes into the game, 5-5 record, coming off a district win against Leake Central. West Lauderdale is undefeated in district play, whereas Choctaw Central has lost two in district. Starting lineups for the visiting Choctaw Central Warriors tonight be number one playing left field, will be Braylon McMillan. Batting second playing center field will be Chris Lewis. Batting third playing third base will be Billy Eisen. Catching and batting in the cleanup slot will be Andreas Jim. Playing right field will be Tatum Nicky. The designated hitter tonight will be Hagen Anderson. Third baseman will be Kirsten Graham. In the eighth slot will be Cohen Keats playing shortstop. In the ninth slot will be Cashton Grissom playing second base. And on the mound tonight for the Warriors will be Xander Saki. The Warriors are coached by head coach Todd York, assisted by Adam Johnson and Kendall Steve. For the homestanding Knights, starting lineup will be Leighton Jenkins playing shortstop, Braden Neptune hitting second, playing second base, Cade Kennedy in the three-hole playing left field, Brooks Buchanan in the cleanup position playing center field, Brett Busby in the fifth slot playing third base, Mason Willis in the sixth slot in pitching, Kamandre Cole will play first base, and Tanner Parker will catch.
Thank you.
field. This afternoon's contest features the visiting Choctaw Central Warriors and the West Lauderdale Knights. The Warriors are led by head coach Todd York. And now your starting lineup and batting order for the Choctaw Central High School Warriors. Starting in left field, number one, Braylon McMillan. In center field, number 21, Chris Lewis. In third base, number seven, Billy Isom. Behind the plate and catching, number 17, Josh Andreas Jim. In right field, number three, Peyton Mickey. The DH, number 26, Hayden Anderson. In first base, number 10, Kurgan Grisham. In shortstop, number eight, Cohen Keats. And in second base, number five, Cashin Grissom. On the mound and pitching for the Warriors, number 13, Xander Saki. The Warriors are led by head coach Todd York, assisted by Adam Johnson and Kendall Steed. And now the White Knights are led by head coach Jason Smith. And now your starting lineup and batting order for the West Lauderdale Knights. Starting at shortstop, number three, Layton Jenkins. The second base, number 17, Brady Epstein. In left field, number 31, Dave Kennedy. In center field, number 23, Brooks Buchanan. In third base, number one, Brett Busby. On the mound, pitching, number 33, Mason Willis. In first base, number 24, Kamandre Cole. Behind the plate, catching, number five, Tanner Parker. And in right field, number two, Jackson Parker. The Knights are led by head coach Jason Smith, assisted by Jody Hurst, Dustin Hamrick, and Jamie Brown. And now, if you would please stand and remove your hats for the invocation and the playing of the national anthem. Our most kind and gracious Heavenly Father, we thank you, Lord, for another beautiful day. We thank you, Lord, for this time that we are taking to play the game of baseball among two schools that are representing their communities. We ask you, Lord, to go with us, guide and direct us, keep all safe. We ask it all in Jesus' name. Amen.
As always, we'd like to send a big thank you out to Stephen Sullivan for taking the time out of his day to come and set up the camera and equipment. We acknowledge him every broadcast because he truly donates his time, and West Lauderdale Athletics really appreciates it. Without him, this wouldn't happen, so we can't thank him enough, and he deserves a lot of accolades. You see him around, thank you for taking the time to do this. We can all view it from home. The weather tonight is a 74, one of the nicer days we've had in a while. Been very nice today. No breeze to speak of. If there's any blowing at all, it's blowing lightly out the center field. Don't look for it to cause immense trouble tonight. Mason Willis enters tonight's game with an ERA of 1.02, 50 Ks and 32 innings pitched. He's got one loss on the year. That loss came early in the season against Starkville, the 3-2 defeat. Went up there, I think it was second, third game of the year. The Warriors and the Knights have a couple of common opponents, League Central being one, which the Knights won, beat 16-0. The Warriors defeated League Central 6-4. They also defeated Northeast 5-0, and the Knights took two games from the Trojans by the score of 19-0 and 12-1, respectively. Leading off for the Warriors would be number one, Braylon McMillan, playing left field. Ball down, low. You always like to get ahead of that first hitter, the first pitch. That hit him. Ball inside on the hands. There'll be a runner on first. So the Warriors get the leadoff runner on first by hit by pitch. Coming up now will be Chris Lewis, center fielder, in the two hole. Pick to first. Back in plenty of time. Let's see if we can get ahead of this hitter right here. There's a pitch. I don't know what to call. Waiting for the umpire to give us a signal. That's a pass ball right there. Going to be a man on second. Ground ball at the middle. It's going to be a tough play for Layton. Runs well. And they got him. One out at first. Good job by Layton. Getting rid of that ball quickly. Be one away. Runner on second. Billy Isom coming to the plate for the Warriors. One out in the inning. Braylon McMillan stands at second base for Choctaw Central. Breaking pitch. Center cut. Swing and a miss. Strike one. Ball inside. One and one. Choctaw Central takes a long time. We got the numbers on the cards, calling a number, having to read the signal. Slows gameplay down considerably. There's a strike, center cut, one and two. Breaking pitch, fouled off. Right-hand side, still 1-2 count. One out, runner on second. Top of the first, 0-0. Good fastball right there. Strike three. That'll be two outs in the inning. Andreas Jim, the catcher, coming to the plate for the Warriors. Cleanup hitter. Puts his foot on the back half of the chalk, the right-handed batter's box. Deep in the box. Strike the knees, 0-1 count. Good fastball, good location right there. Got ahead of the hitter. It's the first one he's been ahead of the night. Good breaking pitch. That's hit good by Jim out to right field. Jackson Parker settles under as it makes the play. And so, the end of the top half of one, score is 0-0. Choctaw had no runs, no hits, no errors. Leading off the Knights, shortstop Layton Jenkins. Jenkins comes into the Knights contest, hitting 340 in leadoff spot. Xander Saki pitching for the Warriors. Ground ball, takes a nasty hop, the shortstop can't handle it, and Jenkins is on first. Reached on an error. First pitch, hit it hard right at him, one hop, took it off the chest. Brayden Epting coming to the plate. Brayden playing second base tonight. Jenkins on first is always a threat to steal. Ball down, 1-0 count. Pitcher takes a good while to get it to the plate, make his delivery. Wouldn't be shocked to see if Layton tries to take second right here. There he goes. Maybe a hit and run. Hit to third. Throw to first. In time. Epstein's retired, but Layton Jenkins moves to second. Puts a runner in scoring position for Cade Kennedy. Cade Kennedy's all having a good year so far, hitting 438, 5 home runs, 29 RBIs. Definitely a big bat in the lineup for the Knights. Had a really good game against Northeast last Thursday. 3-for-4. Curveball. Of the outside corner, strike one. Imagine Cade's going to see his fair share of those for the rest of the year. This is the kind of pitcher you got to wait on. Got to really wait on the ball to get there. Hit him. So Kennedy hit by pitch will take first base. Get the nice runners at first and second. Cleanup hitter Brooks Buchanan coming to the plate. Brooks has had a solid season to this point, hitting 391, playing center field. One home run on the year. Kennedy's got a short lead at first. He's not going anywhere unless Layton goes. He gets off a bit. Runner pushes. First baseman plays behind him. Fouled off to the right-hand side. And off the top of the dugout. So at one point, the first baseman was holding Kennedy on and decided to play behind him, which is the right play, considering Kay's not going anywhere with Layton at second. So that'll give Kay the chance to get a few extra steps. 0-1 count to Brooks. Ball outside, 1-1, breaking pitch. Ball in the dirt. It's a good job by Kay. Check to see if Layton went. Layton didn't go. Kay retreated back to first base. Reading the ball in the dirt. Anytime that ball goes in the dirt, that runner's going to get that great secondary, looking to take that extra base if it gets away. There's a base hit up the middle. Hard hit ball from Buchanan. Layton's going to come around. He's going to hold him at third. It's a good play. Hard hit ball by Brooks. Right up the middle. Brett Busby coming up. Brett Busby also off to a good start. 16 RBIs in the year, 417 average. Brett swinging a good bat right now. Warriors have nowhere to put Brett. Ducks on the pond for Brett Busby. See if he can do some damage right here. Ball outside, 1-0. There's a drive deep down left field side, hook and foul. Brett hit it hard. Stayed in the park. Left field corner, but hooked foul. One count, one out in the inning. Jenkins at first, Kennedy at second, Buchanan at first, excuse me. Ball high, 2-1. Jenkins at third, Kennedy at second, Buchanan at first. 2-1 count to Busby, one out. 0-0 score, bottom of one. Ball hit out the center, high. See if Jenkins is going to tag, make him make a play. Here comes Layton. Throw comes in, and he scores easily. Kennedy does a good job. Takes third on the play as well. Buchanan stays at first. So on the sack fly from Busby, the Knights will take a lead of 1-0. Coming to the plate to be the pitcher, Mason Willis. Runners in the corners. Two outs. See if Mason might take one pitch here, give Brooks a chance to get to second base. Pitcher's got a slow delivery. Not a lot of velocity on his pitches. Takes a long time to get there. There it is. 1-0. Brooks takes second. Now two runners in scoring position. 1-0 count. Strike on the outside corner, 1-1. I think Mason looks at the umpire like maybe he wants that call when he's on the mound. Pitch taking a long time to go through the signals, asking him to reset. There's a drive in the center. Center fielder's on his horse, can't get it. It's going to roll to the wall. It's going to clear him, and Willis will go in with a stand-up double. Make the score 3-0 Knights on a two-out double to center field. Wyatt Castle enters the courtesy runner for the pitcher. Well, that's what we needed. Get on top early. Don't need to let teams hang around when you get a chance to capitalize on it. That's exactly what the Knights have done. This inning, get guys on base and find a way to get them home. 1-0 count, ball in the dirt. Outside, DeMond. Commandre Cole hitting. Commandre Cole's hitting .343 on the year. Swinging a good bat. Really been a double machine. Strike, outside corner, fastball. Curveball high, pass ball. Castle will take third. 2-1 count now to Commandre. Swing, fouled straight back. Mon had a good cut at that one. 2-2 count, two outs. Knights have already pushed three across in the inning. Wyatt Castle stands at third base. There's a good ball right there by Mon. Good job of hitting. Breaking ball stayed up. Got out over the middle of the plate. Commandre made him pay for it. Line drive single to left center. And score Castle to make it 4-0 Knights. Tanner Parker, catcher for the Knights, coming up. Swing and a miss. 0-1 count to Parker. Ball was low and away. Might have been a little bit out of the zone. Tanner chased it. Looked good to him. Umpires called a couple of those strikes, though, in this bottom half of the inning. So if you're Tanner, you kind of got to know that. Probably a pretty good swing at it. 1-1. Fouled off, 1-2. Two outs in it. Mondre Cole at first. Fly ball. High on the infield. Shortstop's got it. Makes a play to end the inning. Retires Parker. But at the end of one, the Knights get four on three hits and one error by the Warriors. Score is Knights 4, Choctaw Central 0. Leading off for Choctaw Central will be the right fielder, Tatum Nicky.
Leading off for the Warriors, right fielder number 3, Tatum Nicky.
Fouled off. Fastball, 0-1 count. First pitch ever, first man out. What you want every inning as a pitcher. So we're ahead 0-1 to the hitter. Line drive to second baseman. Picked up by Epstein, thrown to first. Mine makes the scoop. That's one away. Hagan Anderson coming to the plate for the Warriors, DH. Ball one. Curveball outside half. Must have missed away. Swing and a miss. High fastball. 1-1 count. Ball 2, 2-1. Mm-hmm. There's one center cut, 2-2. Good breaking pitch. Good play by Leighton right there. And misplayed it first. That's an error. And so the Warriors have a runner on first base. It was a good throw by Jenkins, just misplayed over there at first. And now hitting Kirsten Graham, third base. Strike one, center cut, fastball, 0-1 count. O-2 count. There's that outside corner pitch he wanted. Inside corner of the left-hander. It's 0-2, one out. Runner on first. Breaking pitch away. 1-2. You'd like your two-strike pitches, if you're going to miss with them, to be competitive misses. Have them near the plate. Somewhere the hitter has to make a decision. It's a fastball. Could be two right here. See if we can turn it. And we can't handle it at first again. So it's two outs. Man on first. So it was turned. Double play was turned successfully. Just couldn't make the play at first. Cohen Keats, shortstop. It's up for the Warriors. Fastball over the outside half, swing and a miss. 0-1 count. Two outs in the inning. One and one. Missed the curveball inside part. There's a base hit, right up the middle. Cashin Grissom coming up, second baseman for the Warriors. Warriors have two men on one hit. A couple of errors by the Knights in this inning. Strike inside corner, 0-1. Good breaking pitch right there, 0-2. Might follow it up with the same pitch again. He looked awful in that one. It's a good pitch right there, 1-2. Good location. Just didn't get the call. He might throw that one more time so he can get a swing and miss. To the back of the fastball, gets a swing and miss anyway. So the Knights get out of the inning. The Warriors get two men on one hit, a couple of errors by the Knights. Through 1.5, the score's West Lauderdale 4, Choctaw Central 0.
Thank you.
leading off the bottom half of the second. For the Knights, it'll be Jackson Parker. Jackson Parker playing right field. Jackson Parker actually leads the team on on-base percentage of .556 on the season. Jackson's getting on base about half his at-bats. Draws a lot of walks. Able to bunt for hits. Finds a way to get on base. Third baseman's playing in, anticipating the bunt from Jackson. Left-handed, runs well. A strike on the outside corner. I think that was a little out. Jackson didn't like that pitch. One and one. Ball low and away. Jackson is a slow roller to first. That's trouble. Yep. Pitcher never left the mound to cover first. Knew as soon as he couldn't get there, Jackson was going to beat him. Not sure if that's a hit or an error, but I don't think either way, if the first baseman fields that ball, they're going to get Jackson Parker on that. He's too fast. Pitcher couldn't get there in time. So, nice get a leadoff runner on. Back to the top of the order. Layton Jenkins up. Layton reached on an error his last time up. Hard hit ball to the shortstop. Drive into the hole. It's a single by Jenkins. Jackson's going to hold it second. So runners on first and second. Nobody out. Braden Neptune at the plate. Good speed on the base pass for the Knights. Ball gets thrown away. Jenkins going to try to get three. And he's in there. Jackson got to third. Got a little sloppy baseball from the Warriors. Layton moves up to second, so now that takes the force out of play. Much better situation now for the Knights as far as the scoring opportunity. No force in play. Ball in the dirt. 1-0 count. Warriors have some action in their bullpen. Right-hander. Jenkins on second. Nobody really holding him on. 2-0. Ball outside. Called strike. 2-1. Ray Neptune hits a fly ball to center field. Jackson Parker's going to tag. Crow's going to come to third. Layton's going to retreat to second. That's a good job right there. Jackson Parker scores, making the score 5-0 Knights. Sacrifice fly for Epstein. Jenkins remains at second base with one out. Cade Kennedy coming to the plate. Cade hit by a pitch his last time up. Cade's got 5 home runs on the year. There's a good chance if he gets a fastball in the center cut of the plate, you might see one right here. Ball outside and away. 1-0 counts Kennedy. Ball in the dirt, 2-0. One out in the inning. Jenkins stands at second. Knights already pushed one run across in this inning. Knights have 5 hits in the game so far. There goes Jenkins. Go to third. That ball's hit deep to left center. And gone over the 1994 sign. Cade Kennedy delivers 6th home run on the year. And that'll make the score 7-0. Somebody had texted me earlier wanting a holy cow. Well, holy cow! Cade Kennedy hit that one a ton. Brooks Buchanan coming to the plate. Brooks singled his last time up. There's the drive deep to left. Back to the track. And he made the catch right in front of the Cash Saver sign. Brooks gave it a ride. Just a step short. So that's 2 outs in the inning. Brett Busby coming up. Brett Busby had a sacrifice fly his last time up. It's ball 2. 2-0 is the count. Brett's got 1 RBI on that sacrifice fly last inning. Scored 7-0 Knights. And called strike. 2-1. A little high and inside. Strike zone seems to be a little bit erratic tonight. It's not making a lot of difference. Score 7-0, but seems kind of inconsistent. A 3-1 count. 2 outs. There's the drive. Hard hit ball in the left field. Single for Brett. Mason Willis returns. Brett's going to try to get to second. And that was ill-advised. That'll retire the inning. 3 outs in the inning. Busby singles, gets thrown out trying to get to second base. The end of two, the Knights have seven runs on seven hits. The score is 7-0 Knights. So back to the top of the order for Choctaw Central. Braylon McMillan, left fielder, leading off. There's a strike outside corner. Fastball. Another fastball, 0-2. He's got him set up right here for something all speed. Change up, curveball. See if we'll give him a competitive 0-2 pitch. Maybe a curveball low and away in the dirt. See if he'll chase it. Something he can't hit but good enough to want to offer at it. There it is. Strike three inside corner. Well-placed pitch on the breaking pitch. One away. That was a good one. Started his shoulder. Broke it off in the inside half. Chris Lewis, center fielder, coming up. Two-hole hitter for the Warriors. Fouled off. Again, he's ahead 0-1. Breaking ball. Outside, 1-1. Fastball, fouled off, 1-2. Might follow that up with the change up here, low and away. See if he'll chase it. That was the change up a little bit. 1-2 count, fouled off. Left-hand side out of play. Curveball outside, 2-2. Ball high, 3-2. And ball four walked him. Hit it back by the hitter. Lewis fouled off several competitive pitches. Worked it into a walk. Warriors have runner on first. Billy Isom, three-hole hitter, playing third base tonight, Choctaw Central. See if we can keep something down here and get a double play. Ball one low, 1-0. Swing and a miss, 1-1. Runner doesn't have much of a lead at first. One and one count, 7-0 Knights, top of three. Fastball inside half, 1-2. Foul straight back off the hands. Good breaking pitch right there. That'll be strike three. That's two away in the inning. You could almost see that one coming a mile away. Gotten three or four fastballs in a row, trying to catch up to it. Had him completely off balance with a good breaking pitch on the inside half of the plate. Andreas Jim, cleanup hitter for the Warriors coming up. Good curveball right there, 0-1. The last three or four curveballs Mason's thrown, he seems to have found the location. He's been hanging them up high and away, but he's found it now. It's a little tighter, a little sharper break, in and at the bottom half of the strike zone. Maybe settling in a little bit. Another one inside corner, another breaking pitch, 0-2. It's two breaking pitches to Jim. See if he tries to bust him inside with a fastball here. High and tight. Goes away and he gets him. Strike three outside corner. I don't think Jim agreed with it, but the umpire has called that pitch a strike. So far tonight. So halfway through third, Knights lead 7-0. No runs on, no hits for the Warriors. No errors in the Knights.
Thank you.
So for the Warriors, Hagan Anderson, the DH, moves to the mound. The pitching change. Leading off for the Knights will be Mason Willis. 1-for-1 on the night with a double last time up. Drove in a couple of runs. And a fly ball high in the air, drifting out to the left-hand side. And off the top of the dugout. Gets out of play. 0-1 count. There's a drive into center field. Center fielder's ranging over, though, and makes a good catch. Hard hit ball. Center fielder ranged over, made the play. One out in the inning. Demondre Cole coming up. Cole's 1-for-1 on the night on single to left last time up. Drove in one run. There's a single up the middle right there from Comandre. Hard hit ball. First base, we're going to have a courtesy runner, or a pinch runner, excuse me. Cooper Luke's going to go run for Comandre. So Knights have one out, man on first. The former Cooper Luke. Tanner Parker coming up. Tanner's 0-for-1 on the night. See if he can drive Cooper around through the first. Cooper's back in plenty of time. Really shading Tanner to pull. Ball inside. Gets away from the catcher. Well, that's a pass ball. We'll get Cooper Luke to second. One oh count on Parker. There's a hard hit ball by Tanner. Left fielder over his head. Off the fence in left field. Cooper Luke's going to turn and try to score. It's going to be a play at the plate. And it's a wild throw up the line. Tanner's going to, was his second. It's going to end up a third on the overthrow. So we got a stand-up double for Parker. Drives in a run, makes the score 8-0 Knights. And Tanner will take the extra base in the overthrow of home. Courtesy runner Matt Etheridge enter the game for Tanner, third base. And Tanner's brother Jackson Parker comes to the plate. One out in the inning. So that's three hard hit balls in this inning from the Knights. A line drive by Mason Willis to center field that was caught. Line drive by Comandre up the middle. And then Tanner Parker hits a laser beam over the left fielder's head. It's the ball outside. Ball outside again, 2-0. It's really not close to the zone at all. Not even close enough to make Jackson consider swinging. It's about halfway in the middle of the right-hander box. Jackson's toe in the line on the left-hander's box, crowding the plate a little. Could be forcing that pitch the way Jackson's crowding the plate. Pitcher may be pitching away from it a little bit. It's the strategy some teams use, crowd the plate. Make them want to throw you inside. A lot of pitchers don't want to try that. There was one inside. Jackson fouled it off on a 3-0 count. Had the green light. Took a cut at it. Count moves to 3-1. One out in the inning. Etheridge stands on third after Parker's double and an overthrow. Moved him to third base. Etheridge pinch run for him. It's a ball four. That'll get Jackson to first. Knights have runners in the corners. And that'll flip the order over to the leadoff hitter, Layton Jenkins. Jenkins 1-for-2 on the night. Singled to left his last time up. Scored 2 runs. Parker getting a good lead at first. He represents that 10th run. Might try to get him in scoring position. The Knights can somehow keep it scoreless to the 5th. Have a 10-run lead. We can shorten the night. There he goes. Good jump. That hit him. Right off his jersey. Just nicked Layton's jersey. That'll load him up for Braden Epstein. Epstein's on 0-for-1 for the night. Sacrifice fly one time up. Drove in an RBI. Ball, 1-0. One out in the inning, 1-0 count. Bases full of Knights. Graydon swings, fouls it off. Inside pitch. Just nicked it off the handle. Foul back at the screen. One and one count. Ball low, 2-1. Ball inside, 3-1. There's a single through the left side. That's going to score Etheridge from third. Jackson Parker comes around for second. He'll score standing up. Jenkins will hold at second base. So a one-out single by Epstein drives in 2 to make the score 10-0 Knights. Now with one out of the inning, Kay Kennedy returns to the plate. Homer in his last time up. over the 1994 state championship sign. The Warriors have timeout. Maybe making a pitching change. Looks like they're going to the first baseman, Carson Graham. It's a left-hander. Fouled off, popped up to the first baseman. He can't get there. It's off the dugout. Foul ball. One count to Kennedy. One and one count, outside and low. Epstein at first for the Knights, Jenkins on second. Ball high, 2-1. Up and away. Thank you. Ball down. Gets past the catcher and will pass ball. Runners move up 90 feet. 3-1 count, one out. Counts in Kennedy's favor right here. Looking for that fastball. Knowing he don't want to walk him. Loads the bases. Buchanan's up. Next, in the on-deck circle. Good chance Kay gets a fastball right here. He does. Fouled it off the right-hand side. Had a mighty cut at it. Fouled off into the batting cage. So, count goes to full. 3-2, one out. And ball in the dirt. That'll walk him. That'll load him up for Brooks Buchanan coming to play. So Knights have the bags full again. One out in the inning. Brooks is 1-for-2 on the night, scored a run. And fastball up, 1-0. Looks like the Warriors are pulling their infield in on the corners. Don't want to concede a run. Playing double play depth back. Hoping they get a ground ball at the middle, turn two to get out of the inning. Anything hit to the corners, the play should be at home. Brooks hits a fly ball out of deep center field. It's going to stay in play. Runners will tag, move up 90 feet. Kennedy will stay at first. So Jenkins scores to make it 11-0 on sack fly from Buchanan. Epstein moves to third. Brett Busby hitting. Brett Busby's 1-for-1 with an RBI. Also had a sack fly early in the game. The Knights have had productive outs tonight, that's for sure. The no outs, one out. Knights have had 3 sack flies, I believe, to get runners home, which is always good. You can handle outs when they're productive outs. Moving runners along, scoring runners. It's a fly ball. It's on the infield. 2 outs, the runners are in motion. And this play is made by the second baseman. So, the Knights tack on 4 more. And at the end of 3, the score is West Lauderdale 11, Choctaw Central 0. Willis returns to the mound, the top of the fourth inning.
Warriors,
Warriors have the five-hole hitter, Tate Nicky, coming up, playing right field. It's a ball high. 1-0 count. Swing and a miss. 1-1. Ball was up. Nicky chased it. Helping Mason out. There's a fly ball out to the left fielder. Kay coming in. And he can't make the play. That'll drop for a hit. Throw to second. Nicky will pull up with a double. Kind of a bloop double to left field. Hit off the end of the bat. Hagan Anderson, the pitcher. Excuse me, the pitcher that started last innings and back in the DH slot. He comes up. Breaking pitch away. Swing and a miss, 0-1. Started that in the middle of the plate, broke it off. Anderson was fooled completely. Didn't really have an aggressive cut at it. Kind of waved and missed. It's a fastball, high chopper to second. Jenkins comes over, makes a play. So that'll be one out. That's the kind of ball in the high chopper you got to go get. And Layton did just that. It's Kirsten Grissom coming up. Pitching for the Warriors. Warriors have a runner on third base. The fly ball out to left field is going to get foul. O-1 count to Grissom. Stealing home. Squeeze. And the runner's out. Really ill-advised play right there by Choctaw Central, down 11-0. Unless that's just something the coach wanted to work on. An 11-0 game, that's just not really the play you want to run right there. I'm not sure what you gain by doing that. And fouled straight back. So counts 0-2. One out in the inning. Excuse me, two outs in the innings. The runner on third is eliminated in a ill-advised squeeze attempt by Choctaw Central. It was not executed very well. Fouled off right-hand side, 0-2 count. And a fastball gets it past him. So, at the end of 4.5, the Knights lead 11-0. Yeah. Leading off the Knights will be Mason Willis. The bottom of the fourth. Base is one for two. Hit a double over the center fielder's head. And then a hard hit ball right to the center fielder last time up. Set the ball hard twice. A couple of RBIs in the night. And swing and a miss right there, 0-1. Good pitch from the left-hander. Down and away. There's a drive into the right field gap. That's going to get to the wall. Willis going to round first, pull up into second. Stand up double. We got time. Wyatt Castle will courtesy run for the pitcher. And come on, Dre Cole to come to the plate. Mondre Cole's 2 for 2 on the night. One RBI. He's hit the ball hard both times. Ball gets past the catcher. Castle will move up to third. 1-0 count to Mondre. That's another hit for Mon. Little CNI single out to right field. Mon will bring Castle home. Mon's got a nice night at the plate. 3 for 3. Three for three, couple of RBIs for Mon. And I believe that'll do it. That'll be the game for the night. The Knights will win 12-0 by run rule. West Lauderdale traveled to Choctaw Central Friday for the second game in the series. Just a reminder, we're only televising home games at this point. Should that change, we'll let you know. The Knights move to 14-4. Choctaw Central falls to 5-6. The Knights remain perfect in district play. Thank you for listening to us. I hope you enjoy the evening. Hope the broadcast is getting better and better every week. I enjoy bringing it to you, and I hope you enjoy it. Have a good evening and an even better tomorrow. Good night from West Lauderdale Baseball.